Hello everyone, welcome back. In the previous video, we set up the inputs for our character. So we set up our jump, punch, and moving commands for our character inside the project settings. I did want to mention one thing about the project settings here, especially the input section that we've been working in. In case you were wondering, the changes that you make inside the inputs here are automatically saved to the default input INI file. So in case you were wondering, how do I save these settings that I made? You don't have to do that. It's automatically done for you. So I just wanted to mention that. In this video, we're actually going to create a custom material to apply to our character instead of using the default material. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to close the project settings window here. And inside the content browser, we're going to go to the character folder here. And there's the default material that was created when we imported our skeletal mesh here that is currently applied. So if I double click to open up our skeletal mesh, there you can see the default material. We close that now. We're going to create our own material. Now, I realized in the opening video of this series that the character that I showed for the final result did not have this custom material applied. But let's just pretend that he did have that material applied that we're going to create here together, because I do not want to re-record that video. So let's continue. Let's create our material by right-clicking in the content browser here. And it's going to give us a context menu where we can create several different types of assets. But towards the middle of this context menu, there is our material option. So let's go ahead and select material. It's going to ask us to enter a name for it other than new material. So we're going to call it the character material. That seems like a good name. And what we're going to do is create how our material looks inside of this material here. And then what we're going to do is create what's called a material instance of this material and apply that material instance to our character. Now, the material instance will have some settings in it that will allow us to kind of customize how the material actually looks. It's just going to make things easier for us if we want to do some customization down the road. And you'll kind of see how this comes together here in a moment. So let's go ahead and double click on the character material here to open it up. And that's going to open the material editor. Now, the material editor is pretty exhaustive. There's a lot of things in here that you can do. We are not going to go too in-depth in this video. We're just going to create a basic material to apply to our character. But if you'd like to learn more about materials, I kind of wanted to show you where you could do that. So I drag in a window here really quickly. If you go to docs.unrealengine.com, you'll actually end up on the main documentation page. But under engine features and graphics, there's a section on materials that will break down all the bells and whistles of materials and the things that you can do, as well as some step-by-step guides and how to create cool snow effects like this. That looks pretty cool. So if you'd like to learn more about materials in depth, please feel free to hop over to this section and take a look at this documentation to further your knowledge on materials. Let me slide that back off screen. So let's continue creating our basic material here. First thing I'm going to do is hold down right mouse button to kind of drag and move around inside our graph here. What we're going to do is right click and release to bring up a context menu. And first thing that we need to add is a vector parameter node. So go ahead and type in vector parameter. It'll give you the option to add that. And vector parameter is essentially for numbers for RGB and alpha here. And parameter meaning that we can change it later via material instance. So inside the details panel over here on the left, we can rename this. Let's actually just call it base color, like so. And if we want, we can also click this little option here for the default value of the color. Now you can assign any color that you want just by using the standard color picker here. I'm just going to use like an orangish color. So, and hit OK. And you can see the node has been updated. If you don't, make sure that live preview is checked. I don't know if it is or isn't by default, but go ahead and enable live preview so that you can see the updates. Now, if we hold left mouse button and drag off of this pin here and connect it to our main material attributes node inside the base color, you can see it gives us a green check mark and release. Our material preview window will update with our color. Now we could use this if we want, have an orange character that runs around, but we're going to make some modifications to this to give it a little bit more custom, more of a custom look. So I'm going to break this really quickly by right-clicking and choosing Break Links. And the first node that we're going to add to customize a material here is if I right-click and search for Fresnel, F-R-E-S-N-E-L. And this is going to give me another opportunity to kind of showcase some other features inside Unreal for help. If you hold Control and Alt when mousing over a node, you'll get an expanded tooltip that kind of gives you more information on what the node does. In case you were wondering what Fresnel does, there is the tooltip right there. In short, Fresnel determines how the light you see reflects at different intensities based off the angle you are viewing it from. In case you're wondering, you can also get more documentation if you click this See Full Documentation page option. It'll take you to a page specifically about Fresnel. So let's make some changes to the Fresnel setting really quickly. I left-clicked on the node. Inside the Details panel, we have this Base Reflect Fraction setting. I'm just going to actually zero that out. And some of the other nodes that we need to add, let's hold L on our keyboard. We're going to add a Linear Interpolate node. So let's add that. Again, Control-Alt to give you a little bit more information about a Lerp node. And what we're going to do is take the output from the Fresnel and plug that into the alpha of the Lerp. The next thing that we're going to do is take the output from our base color here and plug that into the A of the Lerp. And then we're going to take the base color again. We're going to take that output again, and we're going to search for a power node. We're actually going to multiply this base color by itself just to give us a little bit more of a punch to our material here. And we're going to plug that into the B. Then that output from the Lerp, we're going to plug that into the base color. And there's two more things that we want to do. We want to add some roughness and metallic settings to it. So what we're going to do now is right-click and search for a scalar parameter node. And a scalar parameter is essentially one number, and parameter again meaning that we can change it. Let's actually call this metallic. So M-E-T-A-L-L-I-C. I can spell. And let's plug that into metallic up here. And I'm going to hit, can I Control C and Control V? Yeah, I can. Control C and Control V, the metallic scalar parameter. Inside the details panel for the copy, let's actually rename this. We're going to rename this to roughness. And we're going to plug that into the roughness attribute. Now you can see our material has a bit of a shiny effect to it. It looks a little bit better. Let's actually click on our roughness here, and let's actually set our default value to, say, 0.2 instead of 0, like so. So that looks pretty cool. So I'm going to hit Apply, and I'm going to hit Save, and then I'm going to close the material. So take a second for our content browser to update here. So there's our material. I'm going to right-click on this. And you can see at the very top of that context menu, we have the option to create material instance. So go ahead and select that. And let's see what the name is. Character material instance. I think that's a fine name. So go ahead and double click and open up that material instance. And now you can see we have the options to override those settings that we've defined in the main material that we created a moment ago. So I can click this checkbox here, and now I can change the color to anything I want without changing the main material. So I could change it to purple or whatever I want. I can also hop down to those scalar parameter values and change the metallic settings if I want, or I can change the roughness. So it just gives us some options to kind of play with. It makes things easier down the road, so we don't need to actually update our main material that we created every time. So let's save all. And let's actually apply this material to our character. So let's open up our skeletal mesh here just by double clicking. And it's going to open us right to that mesh tab of persona here. And over in the mesh details, we have the options to define materials for our character here. I'm going to pull this tab off really quickly so you can kind of see how we're going to do this here. Now, there's a couple ways you can apply materials. You can actually drag and drop the character material instance onto a material inside the persona editor here, and it'll apply that material. It'll just take a second, just for a second, for it to compile. Or you can also click this little arrow here to assign whatever is currently selected inside the content browser to this setting here. So if I click this arrow, it says use selected asset from the content browser. That's going to add that material as well. Now, this character actually had some different settings for materials here. I believe this is actually the Unreal logo for the default skeletal mesh. For us, we're just going to use the same material to kind of cover it up so he's not using two different colors. It looks fine. So we're about 11 minutes in. We're actually going to pause here. I think we've got far enough. Actually, let's save really quickly before we do anything else. Save all of our assets. In the next video, let's save one more time. In the next video, we are going to take a look at blend spaces and create our first blend space. So we'll go from idle, walk, to run. And we'll actually talk about the theory behind blend spaces and how they work. So let's wrap up here, and we will see you in the next video.